What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial, and today I want to show you that how to use string in Android Studio. So without wasting any time, let's go to the Android Studio. We have the last project, and from the last project I have removed the second activity and its corresponding XML file. So we have a blank main activity. I have completely cleaned the file and now it's a brand new project. So now I'm moving to that main activity and simply adding some of the things that can show a text view or text from the string. So string is nothing but a group of text that can be registered by a single name, just like a variable that we have written, that we have given for the buttons. So first of all, I'm adding a text view into the sender. I'm adding another button. So the reason why I add the text view and the button is that both of these items can show text inside that. So once I have done this one, I'm going to the rest folder, and inside that, moving to the values, opening it and going to the strings.xml. And you can see here is actually a string is already added. That is, the string name is app underscore name. That is the application name. First application. So I want to add another or new string into it. So let's go and type a new string. So for that, we have to add less than symbol than string. So when you type string and press enter, it automatically complete all the other things required. So now you can give the name for the string. I'm just naming my string as text view message. You can give any names, including the numbers also. So likewise, and now I'm closing with the greater than symbol, and it automatically added the closing tag of that string. Now in between this less than and greater than symbol, you have to type your message. So while typing the message, there is some of the best trick that you can use. Let me show you. So for the text view, I'm typing this is my first. So I have typed this is my first application, and if I want to show the first or the application in the second line or a new line, we have a method that we can use, that is backward slash then yen. Now when I type backward slash with including yen without any spaces between these two, you can see now when we are moving to the activity underscore main, we have the text view, going to the text view, text in this case, changing the text into string value. So we have simply type for arch string, and when I type yes, you can see here it is the string text view underscore message. We're just gonna select that one, and wow, you can see here it shows the text view within two lines, that this is my first application. And in the second line, you can see this is the first. This is my first in the first line, and the application in the second line. So likewise, you can use backward slash and end together to make a new line. And so now you know how to create a new string and give a sample message for the strings. Now create the second string for the button text. So I'm typing again string, then and now typing the string value. So now I have created the second string, that is that the string name is button underscore message with the value of click me then symbol. Okay, now let's move to the activity underscore main.xml, add the string, same as that we have done in the text view, add string, selecting the button underscore message, and you can see instantly it changes the text of this button into click me. So that's it. Now I will show you guys that how to set the value of string using the main activity, that is Java programming. So we have declared the text view, buttons and many other things using the string inside the comeback activity or the activity. So likewise, I'm typing the string. So when I type string, you can see here it automatically came up. Now I'm selecting that one. Now as we have done before, I'm giving the name for the string, that is a variable name for the string. I want to name the variable as my string. Okay, so my string equal to, now you have to enter the value of the string that we have done, same as that we have done in the strings.xml. So I'm typing with something else here. This is my message. Wow, You can see it shows errors between that we have typos. So in order to type a message in the Java quotes, you have to use double quotes, and in between that double quotes you have to type your message. So let me show you that. I'm using a double quote, and inside that I'm typing the same message. Now finally we are closing with a semicolon, and that's it. So there is no any error still now. Now I'm adding a new button or the text view into it. So here is my third widget, and you can see the ID for the widget is text view 3. I'm changing the ID into text view string. Now moving to the main activity, I'm showing the text view here. Now I have shown the text view in between the onCreate method. So finally we have to display the message of the string in the text view. So for that, all you have to do is simply type my text view. That is the variable name that I have given for the text view with the ID text view string. Now you have to type dot set text, and next you have to simply give the name of the variable name of the string. So that the variable name is my string. I'm selecting that one, and there is not any errors till this time. And now let's move to the activity underscore main.xml, and you can see here it shows text view, but if you're running it on your live device, you can always see the text view will be replaced with this message, that is, this is my message. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial, and if you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. And if you want tutorials like this in the future, you can probably go and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next tutorial.